Massachusetts. Welcome to this week's edition of On the Spot. I'm your host, Stephanie Finley. This week's show takes another look at the newly renovated Davis Hall. Let's find out more about the services offered at this facility.
Hi, my name is Margaret. I heard the embassy liaison office moved from building 28. Where did it go?
We're right here in the new Davis Hall. We moved the beginning part of February, and we're kind of happy we're here. The whole embassy liaison operation, which consists of two sections, the consular section, which takes care of the passports, the visas, consular reports of birth and retirement services, and of course the Sojourner section. You all know about Sojourners. We're happy we're here because it's a lot easier for people to get around. Where we were before, there were pretty steep stairs, and you know, people come over with little babies and so on, and it's a much more accessible place to the community. Plus, when we're working with the majority of the folks in the community, there's no better place to be than right smack dab in the middle of things where everybody frequents two or three times a day. So if you haven't seen our new facility, by all means, come down and say hello.
I just got here, and as you can see, I'm tired of walking. What do I need to do to get my license?
You need to go to in-processing center if you're just new here in Vicenza City, and they will schedule you for the orientation class. They give you the form in the class that you need signed by the commander, and after that, come and see me again, and we do an appointment for testing.
I heard, is it true that you can't take certain things back to the States when you PCS?
Certain outdoor items have to be scrubbed down and washed free of any main chunks of mud, or gypsy moth or other insects like that. Drug paraphernalia is not authorized to take back. Alcohol, tobacco products, and prescription medications or any kind of medications have to be hand carried. You're authorized to take 1 liter of alcohol that's duty-free, that means tax-free, back to the States. That's per person over 21.
Still to come on the spot, find out more about the services offered at Davis Hall. We'll be right back.
Hi, this is Belinda with MWR. I know you didn't recognize me this time because I'm at Joe Dugan's at the Fat Tuesday party, and we are having a good time. But just in case you missed it, don't worry. Joe Dugan's is having a lot of deployment specials that are going on during the entire month of March that you do not want to miss. So if you want to join the crowd who's joined the crowd, then you want to meet at Joe Dugan's. It's the place to be.
Welcome back to On the Spot. Let's find out more of your questions.
I'm getting out of the military soon, and I was wondering if there was anywhere I could go to get help on starting a new career.
Here at ACAP, we can help you determine what your goals are, what you want to do as far as career-wise goes. We can also give you help in putting together a resume. We also have job banks that are available to you to use to try to locate employers and employment. We can help you with a skills assessment, what your skills are, and based on that, we can pretty much put together a job search plan that's tailored pretty much to suit you personally.
Where can I go to replace my spouse's ID card?
Say cheese.
Now here's where you come to get an ID card for your spouse. Davis Hall, room number 42.
Can you tell me how the central processing facility works?
At this location, you will have representatives from the finance office, housing referral officer, the central processing manager, and the personal service company, as well as the transportation officer for the in-and-out processing, and the medics.
Still to come on the spot, find out more about Davis Hall in this week's Spotlight Question when On the Spot continues.
How do you find out what's on the menu at MWR? Check out Main Dish at various dining locations, like the PX Food Court. We'll tell you about upcoming MWR events and then invite you to join in on the fun and win prizes. So join us at the next main dish, coming soon to a location near you.
There is a new show that's on AFN.
Main Dish, it's food for thought.
Welcome back. Let's find out more about Davis Hall.
What other offices are located here in Davis Hall?
It's the United States Army Reserve and National Guard In-Service Career Counselor. We give all the soldiers at CTAF the opportunity to affiliate or join with the United States Army National Guard or the Army Reserve in their hometown or local state area.
I'm Renee Citrin. I'm Chief of the Family Support Division, which includes oversight responsibility for three major programs, the Army Community Service Program, the Child Development Services Program, and the Youth Services Program. In addition, I'm also the coordinator of Davis Hall, which entails responsibility for ensuring that the building is kept functioning well. In fact, I would appreciate any comments that anybody has concerning the building, whether it's cleanliness or design.
This place is Carson Wagonlit, the community travel agency on post, and our main business is providing plane tickets for official and leisure traveling.
We are the installation transportation office, and we are in charge of handling all in and outbound shipments for the community. And we have also a quality control section that takes care of all the inspections of outgoing packings and inbound.
Now let's move on to this week's spotlight question. What do you miss most about living in the States?
I don't miss anything, really. Italy's a lovely country. The people are kind.
I miss being able to jump in the car and go see my mommy. I miss my mom.
There's less crime.
I miss McDonald's being open 24 hours, being able to go to Walmart, and just being able to go out late at night and shop.
I mean, you're in the middle of a major metropolitan area.
Go into a gas station any time of the day that I want to. Whenever I need gas, that's probably the hardest thing.
You know, you have the Dolomites right there, you have skiing right in the Italian Alps, you have the Riviera.
Well, I'm actually in Bosnia-Herzegovina as part of Operation Joint Guard, and probably the two things that I miss the most is first being able to go see a good movie, eating hot buttered popcorn and sitting back and relaxing at a movie theater, and the other thing is having a bathroom connected and not having to walk through the mud and the muck and the grime to get to a latrine. That's what I miss about living in the States.
Far away, France is a few hours away. Germany's right there. You have the opportunity to go to Switzerland.
The most thing I miss about being in the States is basically the food, like Popeye's fried chicken, Papa John's pizza, eating normal Chinese food, stuff like that. You know, just going out and going wherever you want to go, like 2-3 o'clock in the morning. You know, just going to the corner store, you know, without having to drive 20 miles back to post, stuff like that. That's basically what I'm missing.
You know, what more could you ask for? I don't really miss anything except for my folks. So I guess I do miss something. I miss my parents.
My family, I got to throw my family up in.
Okay. That's it for this week's edition of On the Spot. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you next week here on the spot.
7-0. Come on, let's
have a practice right. Keep going.
8-7-6-5-4. 7-0-6.
Hello?
Pizza delivery. Pizza? Did you order a pizza? Okay, come on up.
Here is your delivery.
The terrorist threat within UCOM is real. Stay alert. Stay alive. Make personal security part of your everyday routine.
Of petty theft cost AFES thousands of dollars each.
Smith, tonight we'll be exploring the many departments of the Vicenza Health Clinic. So let's get started with your questions.
What type of appointments can be made at the main reception desk?
Any appointment for any clinic except for optometry, physical therapy, medical exam, and radiology.
I'd like to know more about the pharmacy. Is it true you can phone in refills?
Yes, ma'am. We do have a phone-in refill system. We do about 200 prescriptions a day here. We try to keep the waiting time down to around 5 minutes. This seems to keep the patients happy.
My question is about primary care. Do we actually have to see the doctor every time we need a medicine change or have a simple question?
That is a good question. The answer is no. You don't have to make an appointment and come in to see the doctor every time you need a medicine change or have a question. Often you can call in, you can speak to a nurse, and very often the nurse will be able to answer the question for you or ask the doctor and get back with you later that day. Things like routine pregnancy testing or a medicine change are available just by calling in and talking to a nurse or stopping by and speaking with one of them. Giving us 24 hours notice, very often we can get things changed in the computer and you can have your medicine the next day. All right, go ahead and open your mouth.
Say ah.
Still to come on the spot, more about the Vicenza Health Clinic. We'll be right back.
Summer's almost here and it's time to make a move down to the Sports and Fitness Center. What better way to get fit and trim than to join in on the fun of aerobics? Classes take place Tuesday and Thursday at 9 a.m. and Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at noon. So what are you waiting for? Get out of that easy chair and head on over to the Sports and Fitness Center. For more information, give them a call at 634-7009.
Welcome back. Let's find out some more of your questions about the Vicenza Health Clinic.
What kind of services are offered in the physical therapy or orthopedic department?
Well, we offer physical therapy here, occupational therapy, and we also have an orthopedic PA. So we can take care of all kinds of musculoskeletal problems that people have. One program that I'd like to mention is we have a back school that we offer once a month. It's the third Wednesday of every month at 1 o'clock here in the clinic. If you'd like to come, it's open to anyone who has an interest in taking care of their back. Just give us a call, 634-7779, and tell the receptionist you'd like to be enrolled in the back school.
I would like to learn about mammograms. What could you tell me?
We have a mammography program here at Vicenza Health Clinic. We offer mammograms with a physician's referral in the computer, which, you know, he can put in for you. 35 years old is the baseline. Once you have your baseline mammogram, you need to come back age 40 and every other year after 40 and until 50, and then 50 it's every year you have a mammogram.
How often should my family members and I get eye exams, and is it hard to get an appointment?
Can you sit back? We recommend eye exams every couple of years as long as there hasn't been a problem in the past, every 2 years for a routine checkup. Right now it takes about 2 to 3 weeks to get for an exam, and that'll vary based on demand.
Do parents have eyes on back of their heads?
I've never seen them personally, but I think maybe my mom and some of my teachers had eyes in the back of their head.
Still to come on the spot, we'll find out how the community nurses help us take care of ourselves. Don't go away. On the spot, we'll be right back.
Stay in shape, I eat right, get enough sleep, and work out regular. To stay in the Army, I don't drink and drive.
Welcome back. Let's find out more about the Vicenza Health Clinic. What does a community health nurse do?
Part of the job of a community health nurse is health promotion activities for the community. Just to name a few, we do sexually transmitted disease classes, HIV classes. We manage a tuberculosis program, and we give self-care classes. But we will also do any class that's health-related for the community. Our goal is to have a healthier community, a more fit Army.
What is a self-care class, and what are the benefits of taking it?
The self-care class is a part of the TRICARE benefits, and it's open to all TRICARE beneficiaries. And what it does is teaches you how to manage minor illnesses and injuries for yourself and your family members. And a few of the benefits are that you get two wonderful books, taking care of yourself and taking care of your child, and you get over-the-counter pharmacy privileges.
I'd like to know, what are some of the key programs that social work services and mental health have to offer?
In the mental health side of the house, we have Colonel Richmond and Francie Thompson, who provides mental health services on an individual or family basis. If somebody wants to come in for a mental health issue, individual counseling, or concerns, they're free to make appointments by calling 7604 or 7403. With social work services, we have two services. We focus mostly on individual as well as marital counseling, but we also cover the family advocacy program. This is different than the ACS side of the house. We provide assessment and treatment for the family advocacy issues that may include spouse abuse, child abuse, family violence, or domestic concerns.
What happens if I don't enroll in TRICARE Prime?
You're going to fall under TRICARE Standard. With TRICARE Standard, if you are referred to a host nation healthcare facility, you will incur a deductible that you have to meet first, and then a copayment, and that's for outpatient care.
If I go back to the States on a visit and something happens to me, am I still covered by TRICARE?
Yes, you're still covered by TRICARE Europe Prime. If your stay there is less than 30 days and you happen to have an emergency situation occur, we do not require any pre-authorization, a call or an official contact with us prior to getting that care. All emergency care is covered. If you plan on getting routine care, actually, if you're traveling in the States, there is no pre-authorization required at this point in time.
This week, we're spotlighting the men and women who work here at the Vicenza Health Clinic. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you here next week on The Spot.
Doctor, give me the news. I got a bad case of loving you.
Check out outdoor recreation. How about a wetsuit? Or boating gear? Or skis? Or a snowboard? Or a fishing pole? Or golf clubs? Or stuff for camping? Outdoor recreation can even provide you with an instructor. So go to outdoor recreation while you're serving in Europe. They'll help you spend your time.
Welcome to this week's edition of On the Spot. I'm your host, Jeff England. Tonight, we're taking a closer look at a serious topic, drinking and driving. On tonight's show, we'll show you what it's like for someone who makes the mistake of driving a vehicle while intoxicated. Now, let's get started with our first question.
What happens when somebody gets stopped on post under suspicion of DWI?
Well, as you can see, it's currently going on here. The first thing they're going to do is stop your vehicle. From there, they're going to ask for your ID card, your insurance, your registration. Upon smelling odor of alcoholic beverage or maybe slurred speech or something along that line that leads them to believe that you have been drinking, What they're going to do at that point is pull you out, give you a field sobriety test. And if at that time they still believe that you might be drunken driving, they'll apprehend you, transport you to the military police station where you'll be administered an Alcomet 5000 test, which will determine what your level of alcohol consumption has been.
What happens when somebody gets stopped off post on suspicion of drunk driving?
Drunk driving can be determined through three methods. Alcohol test machine, which determines someone is intoxicated after 0.8 grams on liter, or a blood test taken to the civilian hospital, and through visual recognition of the psychophysical condition of the driver. To refuse to submit to the legal alcohol test and blood test is equivalent to be found intoxicated. The consequences are confiscation of the driving license for a minimum of 15 days to a maximum of 90 days if it is the first offense, more if involved in a traffic accident. The car will be only released to a sober person with a valid driving license or to the ACI garage, and there is an immediate report to the court.
What is the difference between driving while impaired, driving on the influence, and drunk driving?
They're all basically the same charge. The major difference is driving while impaired is from 0.5 to 0.79, driving while intoxicated is from 0.80 to 0.99, and drunken driving is from 1.0 and above. What you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? You're too bad. You're too rude. You're too bad. You're too rude.
Still to come on the spot, we'll find out about the penalties of drunken driving and how to keep this from happening to you when On the Spot continues.
What you gonna do when they come for you? You chuck it on that one. Chuck it on this one, you chuck it on your mother, and you chuck it on your father, you chuck it on your brother.
For your information, alcohol was involved in nearly 41% of all car accidents over the last 2 years. In about one-third of all traffic fatalities, at least one driver or pedestrian had a blood alcohol concentration of 0.10 or greater. So please, if you're going to drink, don't drive. And if you do drink, drink responsibly.
Welcome back to On the Spot. We continue with tonight's subject, drinking and driving. Let's find out more.
Can I drink as much as he does and still be below the legal limit to drive home?
The best thing is not to try to second guess how much you can drink and drive. The best thing is to do what the Army suggests, and if you drink, don't drive.
What does the Alcohol and Drug Control Officer do?
It's my job to put into action a program for the 22nd ASG that will prevent, identify, and treat substance abuse. And that has to do with supporting the Army for wellness and readiness, and encouraging the community to work together around issues related to substance abuse.
When someone has an accident and they suspect that alcohol is involved, what happens?
All right, sir, what I need you to do is go ahead and take a deep breath and blow until I tell you to stop. Stop. It depends upon the severity of the accident. If they are injured so bad that they're not able to return to the MP station, at that time they'll stay at the hospital and they'll administer a blood test. If they're okay to come back to the MP station, we'll bring them back here and put them on the breathalyzer. And then from that, we can determine what their level of alcohol influence is.
Is there a program that can help prevent people from drinking and driving?
Here at Club V, we offer designated driver cards. You can pick them up at our cash cage, and they're good for that night. He shouldn't be driving.
Still to come on the spot, our spotlight question of the week. Stay with us.
What you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? When you were 8 and you had bad traits, you go to school and learn the golden rule. So why are you acting like a bloody fool? If you get hot, then you must get cool.
Welcome back. For every illegal action, there's a consequence. Now let's find out about the penalties of drunken driving.
The court is now in session.
If this soldier is convicted of drinking and driving under Article 111 of the UCMJ, he would face a possible punishment of a bad conduct discharge, loss of all pay and allowances, and confinement for 6 months. If convicted of a DUI involving injuries, the soldier would face a dishonorable discharge and confinement for a period of 18 months. Now let's suppose the soldier had gotten someone killed. He would be facing a charge of involuntary manslaughter. The maximum term of confinement for that offense is 10 years. If the soldier had killed or injured a local national by drinking and driving off post, he would likely face trial in an Italian court under our Status of Forces Agreement. Offering the soldier punishment under Article 15 is always an option for the command in a drunk driving case. Any of these actions could effectively terminate your career in the military or provide a basis for administrative separation from the service. One thing is sure, drinking and driving always places your career and your future in the military at risk. It's a risk you can always avoid by never drinking and getting behind the wheel.
The accused will now be arraigned.
We've discovered exactly what happens to someone who chooses to drink and drive. Now it's time for your input. Tonight's spotlight question is, what do you do to stop yourself or someone else from drinking and driving?
Usually either my wife will decide who's going to be the designated driver, and when one's the designated driver, the other one drinks. Or else we just have a few drinks at home when we drink, if we drink.
Well, me and my friends do, we designate who's going to be the designated driver before we leave, and that person doesn't drink.
We prescribe a designated driver, if the person has been drinking, to take his keys away from him and ensure that he's not going to be driving that night.
Well, usually when we go out socially, my husband and I take turns as to who drinks and who drives. And there you have it.
That's it for this week's edition of On the Spot. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you here next week, On the Spot.
He shouldn't be driving. I'm gonna go find him right home.
I'm your host, Stephanie Finley, and this is Mika. This week, we're taking a look at the United States Army Veterinary Clinic right here on Caserma Ederle. So why do we need a vet on Caserma Ederle anyway?
Well, primarily, my job is actually sanitary inspections for food, but I also take care of the military working dogs and the dependents animals. So that's why we need a vet here.
Who do I contact after hours if my pet is hurt or sick?
Okay, if we are closed, you can come by and pick up that list of veterinarian off-post, which is just located here, local vet emergencies, and we always have a copy in here.
What services does the vet on post offer?
Well, you can get vaccines here, heartworm checks, and cursory ear, nose, and throat exams. We don't do any surgery here right now. We're in the process of trying to hire an Italian vet. We're having some problems in a legal office, actually, with the contract. But we'd like to offer to where a vet would be here every single day. But so far, we're having some snags. But that is our goal. And then eventually, we'd like to do spaying and neutering here.
What do services cost here?
Services on post, they roughly are a lot cheaper than they would be off post. Our rabies shots are about $5, our distemper and feline. Distemper shots for canines and felines are about $10. Heartworm tests are about $10. If you compare off-post, the markup off-post is probably going to be about 100% more than that.
Still to come on the spot, we'll find out what you and your pets can do on and off-post here in Vicenza.
What comes to mind when you think of Italy? Perhaps drinking cappuccino in a corner bar. or strolling through a tucked away street market. See the sights with a friend and enjoy the local delicacies. Don't let another weekend pass you by. Discover Italy.
Welcome back to On the Spot. Here in Europe, and especially Italy, attitudes and expectations regarding family pets can be a little different.
What problems could I face when I take my pet to Italian vet?
The Italian veterinarians are very competent. You might run into a little language problem sometimes, but we have people here that speak Italian that can help you with that. And we have a list of veterinarians. We can't pick one in particular, but there's a whole list that are perfectly competent.
Do they really let dogs and cats into restaurants?
Public access for animals in Italy is allowed in some places. There are places where there are restrictions on bringing animals, and you will find signs posted at these areas and facilities. In general, if you have a pet outside the home, you must have the pet on a leash, or the pet must be protected with a muzzle.
Why are there so many stray animals around here?
Italy brought in a bunch of cats to control the rodent problem. And the cats have been allowed to breed and just take nature's course on its own. Okay? And there are laws here in Italy saying that animals can't be euthanized. One way they can be euthanized is if the animal is extremely sick or if it's vicious. Okay? That's one reason we don't euthanize. Another thing is people, military too, before the PCS, just dump their animal. Okay? Yeah, it sounds bad, but it's fact of life.
What happens to stray animals in Italy?
Well, there's a no euthanasia policy here in Italy. They bring them to the pound, which are very overcrowded. And they basically don't put them to sleep only if they're extremely vicious or they have a debilitating disease. So they just keep multiplying.
Still to come on the spot, adopting one of your very own. We'll be right back. Welcome back to On the Spot. We're taking a look at the vet clinic on post. If you didn't come to Italy with a pet, that doesn't mean you can't leave with one. The vet clinic is always interested in finding someone to love and care for the many animals that need homes.
Where do adoptable pets come from?
We have two typical animals that we keep in the back. One, they are stray, and we don't have any records on them. We don't know much of them. So if somebody take a stray animal, he absolutely has to do the shots, like the rabies shot and all the distemper. If it's a surrendered animal, like somebody cannot keep his dog for whichever reason, they go back to the States, then we can keep it here. They have to pay like $35 the surrendering fee. And then we have the records. We know everything about that dog.
What's involved with adopting a pet?
We ask them to record, register their animal here. We give them a new tag under the name, and of course it's a big responsibility, so we ask them to be aware of that.
I love animals, but I can't take one back. Can I help?
Sure, if they want to foster the animal while they're here and keep them, that would be wonderful. We keep information on people that want specific breeds of dogs or cats, and then try to marry the people up. But and if someone's TDY and actually adopts a pet while he's here and then bring it back to the States, that's fine too. Because actually bringing a pet back to the States is not, it's not difficult. There's a few things you have to do, and those include 10 days before leaving, you need a health certificate from this office. You bring your animal in, we have an exam. And then you go and you get an export document from the Italian post office. Then with both paperwork, but not the animal, you go see an Italian veterinarian. We have a map and instructions. And you get all your information stamped, and then you go. So it's just sort of prior planning.
This week's spotlight question, what's your favorite kind of pet?
Guinea pig. Yeah, they're easy to take care of, and they don't, like, make a lot of racket.
My favorite type of pet is a dog.
Any particular reason?
Well, they're fun to play with. They're very active, especially my dog.
Dog. Because...
Hedgehog.
I like dogs for real. You know, basically, even though I have a cat at home, I can't have a dog at home because my apartment and my landlord doesn't allow one. So I gotta have a cat. So, you know, we just chill at home and just be chilling. But if I can have a dog, I'd have a dog.
My favorite pet is a cat because they're easy to take care of and they are smarter than dogs.
I like hedgehogs because they're cool. You don't have to ever touch them. They just sit around all day. I mean, you could do anything you want to them. They won't say nothing back.
My favorite kind of pet's a dog. West Highland White Terrier.
Any particular reason?
Yeah, because my wife likes them.
Family pets are so often just that, family. We watch them being born, growing, living, and finally dying. But throughout it all, they love us. Even the cats. And the Vicenza Vet Clinic is here to make sure that we take care of them. That's it for this week's edition. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you next week here on The Spot.
Welcome to this week's edition of On The Spot. I'm Airman Dominique Dickens, and this week our show focuses on summer youth programs. June 15th is a big day. Your kids are out for the summer. It's time for fun, sun, and recreation. Hopefully our show can give you some options on what your kids will be doing around post. But right now, let's take a look at some of your questions.
What are some of the activities that the YS is, like, sponsoring during the summer, and do my parents have to go?
Well, that I'm glad you asked, because we're having our camp sign-up day on May 16th from 10 to 2. We have this in-look book here, which you can find at the post office or around post or at youth services, child development services, school aid services. And in this book covers every aspect that you'd want to know about summer camp, from your day trips for youth services activities, school aid services, drama. The whole works is right in here. And if you have any other questions that aren't covered here, then you can call us at Youth Services at 634-7741.
What summer programs are going to be offered this year?
This year we're offering a variety of programs. We're offering many options for parents. One of the reasons for that is that this command is going to be enforcing, as we actually have been in the past, the home alone policy, and most people know that that home alone policy states that children under the age of 9 cannot be left alone. Those activities include a school age services program which runs from 6 in the morning to 6 in the evening, and that is for working parents. We have a day camp from Monday through Friday that runs from 9 o'clock to 4:30. The school age services program, by the way, will include as part of it the day camp. And then because Youth Services is not running the day camp this year, that has freed up the Youth Services staff to come up with all sorts of programming that run from hourly programs to daily programs to sometimes 3-day programs, field trips, overnight trips, all sorts of activities from Youth Services. And Youth Services will also be open for children from 5 to 18 in these programs.
What costs is involved in the summer program?
Okay. Summer programs depends on which program you're participating in. There are 3 different levels of programming this summer. The 6 to 6 program, which goes from 6 in the morning till 6 in the evening, Monday through Friday. The prices range from $39 to $84 a week, depending on your family income. We have just the summer camp program, the run that goes from 9 to 4:30 Monday through Friday. The cost for that program ranges from $35 to $60 depending on your family income.
Well, in terms of what Youth Services, we have a wide variety of costs, and our costs are based on break even. We We don't really make money on any of our trips, and so it's just a break even, and we cover the direct costs. So, and there's such a wide variety of answers for you, depending on the trip to Gardaland and how much that charges, or the trip to Potavaland, or the Kimsay trip, or the whitewater rafting, or whatever it is. So,
still to come on the spot, more about summer youth programs. We'll be right back.
On my honor, I will try to serve God
and my country, to help people at all times, and to live by the Girl Scout law.
Welcome back to On the Spot. This week we're talking about youth summer programs. Now let's take more of your questions.
What does Outdoor Rec have planned for kids this summer?
Well, our main programs that we offer are is the swimming lesson program, and these swimming lessons are for children ages 3 on up. We offer many different levels. It's the Red Cross programs. Our first session will be starting on June 22nd, and we will be taking registration for that session on May 16th at the PX from 10 to 2 during the YS summer sign-up program. Other things that we offer are family programs. And these activities are such as our water rafting trips. We also have hiking trips. Some of the hikes are more difficult than others. And you can just come in here and see what we have planned for each trip. And we usually have maps of everything that's going on. So we have a wide variety of everything that kids, adults can go on also.
Could you tell me what programs the Soldiers Theater have available for children this summer?
Soldiers Theater's got a wonderful summer drama camp scheduled for 2 weeks. The first one will begin June 15th and run through the 27th of June. And the second camp will begin on August 3rd and run through August 15th. It'll be taught by Bonnie Daniels, who has a master's degree in child drama from Arizona State University and one of the premier child drama specialists in America today. So we have got an extraordinary opportunity for children here and for parents to get their children involved in something that will be life-altering, life-changing for their youngsters.
Will Boy Scouts ask for a camp this summer?
Boy Scouts has a summer camp planned in Germany. You can get details by calling me at 634-8595 or 341-025 at home.
Still to come on the spot, we'll take a look at some of the trips and activities YS has planned for the summer when On the Spot continues.
If you missed ITR's trip to the French Riviera last time, you're definitely not going to want to miss it again. 3 days of touring the sights, shopping, and walking on the beach. What are you waiting for?
Now for tonight's spotlight question. We've been talking about youth summer programs for kids, but now let's talk about what you have planned for this summer.
Go to Germany and tour Germany for a while.
PCSing. Yes.
Well, my wife Kelly and I are going to take our one-year-old son Michael to Livorno and check out Pisa and some of the towns around there.
See, we're going to Crete, Greece. No. I'm going to go back home to Washington.
Well, this summer, in July, I'm going to go on the USS LaSalle and JTF Matador. And I'm going to sail the Mediterranean with the Navy.
That's it for this week's edition. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you next week here.
On the Spot!
Welcome to this week's edition of On the Spot. I'm Airman Dominique Dickens, and this week our show focuses on... you. Welcome to this week's edition of On the Spot. The bomb. Welcome to this. Bah, there you go. One more time.
Come on the spot. We'll take a look
at some of the. Oh, microphone's upside down.
Take a look at some of the trips and activities YS has planned for their summer program.
Now, what's the last part?
What's on my leg like GoPro? We'll be right back.
Hello and welcome to this edition of On the Spot. I'm Jerry Malec. Tonight we'll take a look at some volunteers in the community and we'll answer your questions about what it's like to volunteer on post. There are over 1,100 volunteers on Caserma Ederle, and tonight we'll talk to some of those volunteers. But first, let's get to some of your questions.
Why volunteer?
Volunteering helps you feel good about yourself. It helps with the community, which is really important. The community depends a lot on volunteers. And it gives you something to do if you don't have anything to do.
I volunteer because I like helping other people, and running the tutoring program gives me an opportunity to work with other people and help them learn things for their classes, and it's a lot of fun.
What makes your job as a volunteer so exciting?
I spend most of my time as the program manager for the Army Family Team Building, and I find it very exciting because I get to meet a lot of the new people in the community and actually get to teach a lot, which is something that I enjoy doing. We're offering classes, as a matter of fact, on April 20th and 21st for Level 1 training. If anyone's interested, they can call the ACS building at 8526, and we can schedule them to participate in those classes with us. I find it exciting because it keeps you up on things that are important in the military and important to families in particular.
Still to come On the Spot, more about volunteering. Stay with us.
Hello, I'm Sherry Floyd. I'm the librarian of Vicenza, and this is your library, and I would like to tell you about the programs and services that we have to offer you. We're open Tuesday through Sunday from 11 to 7. Come on, follow me. This is the section in the library where we keep the new books, and if you'll notice, there are many on the bestseller list.
We receive 12 new music CDs each month.
If you'd rather listen to your book, we receive 6 new titles each month. Thanks to some generous year-end funding, we've been able to update the classics in our children's collection. And as all of you know, we have internet access on our public use computer. If you'd like to know more about the programs and services offered at the Post Library, I want you to feel free to come in and ask our very knowledgeable staff. And we want you to
spring into reading!
Welcome back to
Welcome to this week's edition of On the Spot. I'm your host, Stephanie Finley. This week's show takes another look at the newly renovated Davis Hall. Let's find out more about the services offered at this facility.
Hi, my name is Margaret. I heard the Embassy Liaison Office moved from Building 28. Where did it go?
We're right here in the new Davis Hall. We moved the beginning part of February, and we're kind of happy we're here. The whole Embassy Liaison operation, which consists of two sections, the consular section, which takes care of the passports, the visas, consular reports of birth and retirement services, and of course the Sojourner section. You all know about Sojourners. We're happy we're here because it's a lot easier for people to get around. Where we were before, there were pretty steep stairs, and you know, people come over with little babies and so on, and it's a much more accessible place to the community. Plus, when we're working with the majority of the folks in the community, there's no better place to be than right smack dab in the middle of things where everybody frequents 2 or 3 times a day. So if you haven't seen our new facility, by all means, come down and say hello.
I just got here, and as you can see, I'm tired of walking. What do I need to do to get my license?
You need to go to in-processing center if you're just new here in Vicenza City, and they will schedule you for the orientation class. They give you the form in the class that you need signed by the commander, And after that, come and see me again, and we do an appointment for testing.
I heard, is it true that you can't take certain things back to the States when you PCS?
Certain outdoor items have to be scrubbed down and washed free of any main chunks of mud or gypsy moth or other insects like that. Drug paraphernalia is not authorized to take back. Alcohol, tobacco products, and prescription medications or any kind of medications have to be hand carried. You're authorized to take 1 liter of alcohol that's duty free, that means tax free, back to the States. That's per person over 21.
Still to come on the spot, find out more about the services offered at Davis Hall. We'll be right back.
Hi, this is Belinda with MWR. I know you didn't recognize me this time because I'm at Joe Dugan's at the Fat Tuesday party, and we are having a good time. But just in case you missed it, don't worry. Joe Dugan's is having a lot of deployment specials that are going on during the entire month of March that you do not want to miss. So if you want to join the crowd who's joined the crowd, then you want to meet at Joe Dugan's. It's the place to be.
Welcome back to On the Spot. Let's find out more of your questions.
I'm getting out of the military soon, and I was wondering if there was anywhere I could go to get help on starting a new career.
Well, here at ACAP, we can help you to determine what your goals are, what you want to do as far as career-wise goes. We can also give you help in putting together a resume. We also have job banks that are available to you to use to try to locate employers and employment. We can help you with a skills assessment, what your skills are, and based on that, we can pretty much put together a job search plan that's tailored pretty much to suit you personally.
Where can I go to replace my spouse's ID card?
Say cheese.
Now here's where you come to get an ID card for your spouse. Davis Hall, room number 42.
Can you tell me how the central processing facility works?
At this location, you will have representatives from the finance office, housing referral officer, the central processing manager, and the personal service company, as well as the transportation officer for the in-and-out processing, and the medics.
Still to come on the spot, find out more about Davis Hall in this week's Spotlight Question when On the Spot continues.
How do you find out what's on the menu at MWR? Check out Main Dish at various dining locations, like the PX Food Court. We'll tell you about upcoming MWR events and then invite you to join in on the fun and win prizes. So join us at the next Main Dish, coming soon to a location near you. There is a new show that's on AFN. Main Dish, it's food for thought.
Welcome back. Let's find out more about Davis Hall.
What other offices are located here in Davis Hall?
It's the United States Army Reserve and National Guard in-service career counselor. We give all the soldiers of CTAF the opportunity to affiliate or join with the United States Army National Guard or the Army Reserve in their hometown or local state area.
I'm Renee Citrin. I'm chief of the Family Support Division, which includes oversight responsibility for three major programs: the Army Community Service Program, the Child Development Services Program, and the Youth Services Program. In addition, I'm also the coordinator of Davis Hall, which entails responsibility for ensuring that the building is kept functioning well. In fact, I would appreciate any comments that anybody has concerning the building, whether it's cleanliness or design.
This place is Carson Wagonlit, the community travel agency on post, and our main business is providing plane tickets for official and leisure traveling.
We are the installation transportation office, and we are in charge of handling all in and outbound shipments for the community, And we have also a quality control section that takes care of all the inspections of outgoing packings and inbound.
Now let's move on to this week's spotlight question. What do you miss most about living in the States?
I don't miss anything, really. Italy's a lovely country. The people are kind.
I miss being able to jump in the car and go see my mommy. I miss my mom.
There's less crime.
I miss McDonald's being open 24 hours, being able to go to Walmart, and just being able to go out late at night and shop.
I mean, you're in the middle of a major metropolitan area.
Going to a gas station any time of the day that I want to. Whenever I need gas, that's probably the hardest thing.
You know, you have the Dolomites right there. You have skiing right in the Italian Alps. You have the Riviera.
Well, I'm actually in Bosnia-Herzegovina as part of Operation Joint Guard. And probably the two things that I miss the most is first, being able to go see a good movie, eating hot buttered popcorn and sitting back and relaxing at a movie theater. And the other thing is having a bathroom connected and not having to walk through the mud and the muck and the grime to get to a latrine. That's what I miss about living in the States.
Our way, France is a few hours away. Germany's right there. You have the opportunity to go to Switzerland.
The most thing I miss about being in the States is basically the food, like Popeye's fried chicken, Papa John's pizza, eating normal Chinese food, stuff like that. You know, just going out and going wherever you want to go, like 2-3 o'clock in the morning. You know, just going to the corner store, you know, without having to drive 20 miles back to post, stuff like that. That's basically what I'm missing.
You know, what more could you ask for? I don't really miss anything except for my folks. So I guess I do miss something. I miss my parents.
My family, I got to throw my family up there.
Okay. That's it for this week's edition of On the Spot. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you next week here on the spot.
7-0.
Hello?
Pizza delivery.
Pizza? Did you order a pizza? Yeah, okay, come on up.
Here is your delivery.
The terrorist threat within UCOM is real. Stay alert. Stay alive. Make personal security part of your everyday routine.
Of petty theft cost AFES thousands of dollars each.
Smith, tonight we'll be exploring the many departments of the Vicenza Health Clinic. So let's get started with your questions.
What type of appointments can be made at the main reception desk?
Any appointment for any clinic except for optometry, physical therapy, medical exam, and radiology.
I'd like to know more about the pharmacy. Is it true you can phone in refills?
Yes, ma'am. We do have a phone-in refill system. We do about 200 prescriptions a day here. We try to keep the waiting time down to around 5 minutes. This seems to keep the patients happy.
My question is about primary care. Do we actually have to see the doctor every time we need a medicine change or have a simple question?
That is a good question. The answer is no. You don't have to make an appointment and come in to see the doctor every time you need a medicine change or have a question. Often you can call in, you can speak to a nurse, and very often the nurse will be able to answer the question for you or ask the doctor and get back with you later that day. Things like routine pregnancy testing or a medicine change are available just by calling in and talking to a nurse or stopping by and speaking with one of them. Giving us 24 hours notice, very often we can get things changed in the computer and you can have your medicine the next day. All right, go ahead and open your mouth.
Say ah.
Ah.
Still to come on the spot, more about the Vicenza Health Clinic. We'll be right back.
Summer's almost here and it's time to make a move down to the Sports and Fitness Center. What better way to get fit and trim than to join in on the fun of aerobics? Classes take place Tuesday and Thursday at 9 a.m. and Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at noon. So what are you waiting for? Get out of that easy chair and head on over to the Sports and Fitness Center. For more information, give them a call at 634-7009.
Welcome back. Let's find out some more of your questions about the Vicenza Health Clinic.
What kind of services are offered in the physical therapy orthopedic department?
Well, we offer physical therapy here, occupational therapy, and we also have an orthopedic PA. So we can take care of all kinds of musculoskeletal problems that people have. One program that I'd like to mention is we have a back school that we offer once a month. It's the third Wednesday of every month at 1 o'clock here in the clinic. If you'd like to come, it's open to anyone who has an interest in taking care of their back. Just give us a call, 634-7779, and tell the receptionist you'd like to be enrolled in the back school.
I would like to learn about mammograms. What could you tell me?
We have a mammography program here at Vicenza Health Clinic. We offer mammograms with a physician's referral in the computer, which, you know, he can put in for you. 35 years old is the baseline. Once you have your baseline mammogram, you need to come back age 40 and every other year after 40 and until 50, and then 50 it's every year you have a mammogram.
How often should my family members and I get eye exams, and is it hard to get an appointment?
Can you sit back? We recommend eye exams every couple of years as long as there hasn't been a problem in the past. Every 2 years for a routine checkup. Right now it takes about 2 to 3 weeks to get in for an exam, and that'll vary based on demand.
Do parents have eyes on back of their heads?
I've never seen them personally, but I think maybe my mom and some of my teachers had eyes in the back of their head.
Still to come on The Spot, we'll find out how the community nurses help us take care of ourselves. Don't go away. On The Spot, we'll be right back.
To stay in shape, I eat right, get enough sleep, and work out regularly. To stay in the Army, I don't drink and drive.
Welcome back. Let's find out more about the Vicenza Health Clinic. What does a community health nurse do?
Part of the job of a community health nurse is health promotion activities for the community. Just to name a few, we do sexually transmitted disease classes, HIV classes. We manage a tuberculosis program, and we give self-care classes. But we will also do any class that's health-related for the community. Our goal is to have a healthier community, a more fit Army.
What is a self-care class, and what are the benefits of taking it?
The self-care class is a part of the TRICARE benefits, and it's open to all TRICARE beneficiaries. And what it does is teaches you how to manage minor illnesses and injuries for yourself and your family members. And a few of the benefits are that you get two wonderful books, Taking Care of Yourself and Taking Care of Your Child, and you get over-the-counter pharmacy privileges.
I'd like to know, what are some of the key programs that social work services and mental health have to offer?
In the mental health side of the house, we have Colonel Richmond and Francie Thompson, who provides mental health services on an individual or family basis. If somebody wants to come in for a mental health issue, individual counseling, or concerns, they're free to make appointments by calling 7604 or 7403. With social work services, we have two services. We focus mostly on individual as well as marital counseling, but we also cover the family advocacy program. This is different than the ACS side of the house. We provide assessment and treatment for the family advocacy issues that may include spouse abuse, child abuse, family violence, or domestic concerns.
What happens if I don't enroll in TRICARE Prime?
You're going to fall under TRICARE Standard. With TRICARE Standard, if you are referred to a host nation healthcare facility, you will incur a deductible that you have to meet first, and then a copayment, and that's for outpatient care.
If I go back to the States on a visit and something happens to me, am I still covered by TRICARE?
Yes, you're still covered by TRICARE Europe Prime. If your stay there is less than 30 days and you happen to have an emergency situation occur, we do not require any pre-authorization, a call or an official contact with us prior to getting that care. All emergency care is covered. If you plan on getting routine care actually, if you're traveling in the States, there is no pre-authorization required at this point in time.
This week, we're spotlighting the men and women who work here at the Vicenza Health Clinic. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you here next week on The Spot.
Give me the news. I got a bad case of loving you.
Check out outdoor recreation. How about a wetsuit? Or boating gear? Or skis? Or a snowboard? Or a fishing pole? Or golf clubs? Or stuff for camping? Outdoor recreation can even provide you with an instructor. So go to outdoor recreation while you're serving in Europe. They'll help you spend your time.
Welcome to this week's edition of On the Spot. I'm your host, Jeff England. Tonight, we're taking a closer look at a serious topic, drinking and driving. On tonight's show, we'll show you what it's like for someone who makes the mistake of driving a vehicle while intoxicated. Now, let's get started with our first question.
What happens when somebody gets stopped on post under suspicion of DWI?
Well, as you can see, it's currently going on here. The first thing they're going to do is stop your vehicle. From there, they're going to ask for your ID card, your insurance, your registration. Upon smelling odor of alcoholic beverage or maybe slurred speech or something along that line that leads them to believe that you have been drinking, what they're going to do at that point is pull you out, give you a field sobriety test. And if at that time they still believe that you might be drunk and driving, they'll apprehend you, transport you to the military police station where you'll be administered an Alcomet 5000 test, which will determine what your level of alcohol consumption has been.
What happens when somebody gets stopped off post on suspicion of drunk driving?
Drunk driving can be determined through three methods. Alcohol test machine, which determines someone is intoxicated after 0.8 grams on liter, or a blood test taken to the civilian hospital, and through visual recognition of the psychophysical condition of the driver. To refuse to submit to the legal alcohol test and blood test is equivalent to be found intoxicated. The consequences are confiscation of the driving license for a minimum of 15 days to a maximum of 90 days. If it is the first offense, more if involved in a traffic accident, the car will be only released to a sober person with a valid driving license or to the ACI garage, and there is an immediate report to the court.
What is the difference between driving while impaired, driving on the influence, and drunk driving?
They're all basically the same charge. The major difference is driving while impaired is from 0.5 to 0.79, driving while intoxicated is from 0.80 to 0.99, and drunken driving is from 1.0 and above.
Still to come on the spot, we'll find out about the penalties of drunken driving. and how to keep this from happening to you. When On the Spot continues.
What you gonna do when they come for you? You chuck it on that one, you chuck it on this one, you chuck it on your mother and you chuck it on your father, you chuck it on your brother.
For your information, alcohol was involved in nearly 41% of all car accidents over the last 2 years. In about one-third of all traffic fatalities, at least one driver or pedestrian had a blood alcohol concentration of 0.10 or greater. So please, if you're gonna drink, don't drive. And if you do drink, drink responsibly.
Welcome back to On the Spot. We continue with tonight's subject, drinking and driving. Let's find out more.
Can I drink as much as he does and still be below the legal limit to drive home?
The best thing is not to try to second guess how much you can drink and drive. The best thing is to do what the Army suggests, and if you drink, don't drive.
What does the Alcohol and Drug Control Officer do?
It's my job to put into action a program for the 22nd ASG that will prevent, identify, and treat substance abuse. And that has to do with supporting the Army for wellness and readiness, and encouraging the community to work together around issues related to substance abuse.
When someone has an accident and they suspect that alcohol is involved, what happens?
All right, sir, what I need you to do is go ahead and take a deep breath and blow until I tell you to stop. Stop. It depends upon the severity of the accident. If they are injured so bad that they're not able to return to the MP station, at that time they'll stay at the hospital and they'll administer a blood test. If they're okay to come back to the MP station, we'll bring them back here and put them on the breathalyzer. And then from that we can determine what their level of alcohol influence is.
Is there a program that can help prevent people from drinking and driving?
Here at Club V, we offer designated driver cards. You can pick them up at our Cascades and they're good for that night. He shouldn't be driving.
Still to come on the spot, our spotlight question of the week. Stay with us.
What you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? When you were 8 and you had bad traits, you go to school and learn the golden rule. So why are you acting like a bloody fool? If you get hot, then you must get cool.
Welcome back. For every illegal action, there's a consequence. Now let's find out about the penalties of drunken driving.
The court is now in session.
If this soldier is convicted of drinking and driving under Article 111 of the UCMJ, he would face a possible punishment of a bad conduct discharge, loss of all pay and allowances, and confinement for 6 months. If convicted of a DUI involving injuries, the soldier would face a dishonorable discharge and confinement for a period of 18 months. Now let's suppose this soldier had gotten someone killed. He would be facing a charge of involuntary manslaughter. The maximum term of confinement for that offense is 10 years. If the soldier had killed or injured a local national by drinking and driving off post, he would likely face trial in an Italian court under our Status of Forces Agreement. Offering the soldier punishment under Article 15 is always an option for the command in a drunk driving case. Any of these actions could effectively terminate your career in the military or provide a basis for administrative separation from the service. One thing is sure, drinking and driving always places your career and your future in the military at risk. It's a risk you can always avoid by never drinking and getting behind the wheel.
The accused will now be arraigned.
We've discovered exactly what happens to someone who chooses to drink and drive. Now it's time for your input. Tonight's spotlight question is, what do you do to stop yourself or someone else from drinking and driving?
Usually either my wife will decide who's going to be the designated driver, and when one's the designated driver, the other one drinks. Or else we just have a few drinks at home when we drink, if we drink.
Well, me and my friends do. We designate who's going to be the designated driver before we leave, and that person doesn't drink.
We prescribe a designated driver, if the person has been drinking, to take his keys away from him and ensure that he's not going to be driving that night.
Well, usually when we go out socially, my husband and I take turns as to who drinks and who drives. And there you have it.
That's it for this week's edition of On the Spot. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you here next week on the spot.
He shouldn't be driving. I'm gonna go find him right home.
I'm your host, Stephanie Finley, and this is Mika. This week, we're taking a look at the United States Army Veterinary Clinic right here on Caserma Ederle. So why do we need a vet on Caserma Ederle anyway?
Well, primarily, my job is actually sanitary inspections for food, but I also take care of the military working dogs and the dependence animals. So that's why we need a vet here.
Do I contact after hours if my pet is hurt or sick?
Okay, if we are closed, you can come by and pick up that list of veterinarian off-post, which is just located here, local vet emergencies, and we always have a copy in here.
What services does the vet on post offer?
Well, you can get vaccines here, heartworm checks, and cursory ear, nose, and throat exams. We don't do any surgery here right now. We're in the process of trying to hire an Italian vet. We're having some problems in a legal office, actually, with the contract. But we'd like to offer to where a vet would be here every single day. But so far, we're having some snags. But that is our goal. And then eventually, we'd like to do spaying and neutering here.
What do services cost here?
Services on post, they roughly are a lot cheaper than they would be off post. Our rabies shots are about $5, our distemper and feline. Distemper shots for canines and felines are about $10. Heartworm tests are about $10. If you compare off-post to markup off-post, it's probably going to be about 100% more than that.
Still to come on the spot, we'll find out what you and your pets can do on and off-post here in Vicenza.
What comes to mind when you think of Italy? Perhaps drinking cappuccino in a corner bar. Or strolling through a tucked away street market. See the sights with a friend and enjoy the local delicacies. Don't let another weekend pass you by. Discover Italy.
Welcome back to On the Spot. Here in Europe, and especially Italy, attitudes and expectations regarding family pets can be a little different.
What problems could I face when I take my pet to an Italian vet?
The Italian veterinarians are very competent. You might run into a little language problem sometimes, but we have people here that speak Italian that can help you with that. And we have a list of veterinarians. We can't pick one in particular, but there's a whole list that are perfectly competent.
Do they really let dogs and cats into restaurants?
Public access for animals in Italy is allowed in some places. There are places where there are restrictions on bringing animals, and you will find signs posted at these areas and facilities. In general, if you have a pet outside the home, you must have the pet on a leash, or the pet must be protected with a muzzle.
Why are there so many stray animals around here?
Italy brought in a bunch of cats to control the rodent problem. And the cats have been allowed to breed and just take nature's course on its own. Okay? And there are laws here in Italy saying that animals can't be euthanized. One way they can be euthanized is if the animal is extremely sick or if it's vicious. Okay? That's one reason we don't euthanize. Another thing is people, military too, before the PCS, just dumped their animal. Okay, yeah, it sounds bad, but it's a fact of life.
What happens to stray animals in Italy?
Well, there's a no euthanasia policy here in Italy. They bring them to the pound, which are very overcrowded, and they basically don't put them to sleep only if they're extremely vicious or they have a debilitating disease. So they just keep multiplying.
Still to come on the spot, adopting one of your very own. We'll be right back. Welcome back to On the Spot. We're taking a look at the vet clinic on post. If you didn't come to Italy with a pet, that doesn't mean you can't leave with one. The vet clinic is always interested in finding someone to love and care for the many animals that need homes.
Where do adoptable pets come from?
We have two typical animals that we keep in the back. One, they are stray, and we don't have any records on them. We don't know much of them. So if somebody take a stray animal, he absolutely has to do the shots, like the rabies shot and all the distemper. If it's a surrendered animal, like somebody cannot keep his dog for whichever reason, they go back to the States, then we can keep it here. They have to pay like $35 surrendering fee. And then we have the records. We know everything about that dog.
What's involved with adopting a pet?
We ask them to record, register their animal here. We give them a new tag under the name. And of course, it's a big responsibility, so we ask them to be aware of that.
I love animals, but I can't take one back. Can I help?
Sure, if they want to foster the animal while they're here and keep them, that would be wonderful. We keep information on people that want specific breeds of dogs or cats and then try to marry the people up. But and if someone's TDY and actually adopts a pet while he's here and then bring it back to the States, that's fine too. Because actually bringing a pet back to the States is not, it's not difficult. There's a few things you have to do, and those include 10 days before leaving, you need a health certificate from this office. You bring your animal in, we have an exam. And then you go and you get an export document from the Italian post office. Then with both paperwork, but not the animal, you go see an Italian veterinarian. We have a map and instructions. And you get all your information stamped, and then you go. So it's just sort of prior planning.
This week's spotlight question, what's your favorite kind of pet?
Guinea pig. Yeah, they're easy to take care of, and they don't like make a lot of racket.
My favorite type of pet is a dog.
Any particular reason?
Well, they're fun to play with. They're very active, especially my dog.
Dog. Because...
Hedgehog.
I like dogs for real. You know, basically, even though I have a cat at home, I can't have a dog at home because my apartment and my landlord doesn't allow one. So I gotta have a cat. So, you know, we just chill at home and just be chilling. But if I can have a dog,
I'd have a dog.
My favorite pet is a cat because they're easy to take care of and they are smarter than dogs.
I like hedgehogs because they're cool. You don't have to ever touch them. They just sit around all day. I mean, you could do anything you want to them. They won't say nothing back.
My favorite kind of pet's a dog. West Highland White Terrier.
Any particular reason?
Yeah, because my wife likes them.
Family pets are so often just that, family. We watch them being born, growing, living, and finally dying. But throughout it all, they love us, even the cats. And the Vicenza Vet Clinic is here to make sure that we take care of them. That's it for this week's edition. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you next week here on the spot.
Welcome to this week's edition of On the Spot. I'm Airman Dominique Dickens, and this week our show focuses on summer youth programs. June 15th is a big day. Your kids are out for the summer. It's time for fun, sun, and recreation. Hopefully our show can give you some options on what your kids will be doing around post. But right now, let's take a look at some of your questions.
What are some of the activities that the YS is like sponsoring during the summer, and do my parents have to go?
Well, that I'm glad you asked, because we're having our camp sign-up day on May 16th from 10 to 2. We have this in-lookbook here, which you can find at the post office or around post or at youth services, child development services, school aid services. And in this book covers every aspect that you'd want to know about summer camp, from your day trips for youth services activities, school aid services, drama. The whole works is right in here. And if you have any other questions that aren't covered here, then you can call us at Youth Services at 634-7741.
What summer programs are going to be offered this year?
This year we're offering a variety of programs. We're offering many options for parents. One of the reasons for that is that this command is going to be enforcing, as we actually have been in the past, the home alone policy, and most people know that that home alone policy states that children under the age of 9 cannot be left alone. Those activities include a school age services program, which runs from 6 in the morning to 6 in the evening, and that is for working parents. We have a day camp from Monday through Friday that runs from 9 o'clock to 4:30. The school age services program, by the way, will include as part of it the day camp. And then, because Youth Services is not running the day camp this year, that has freed up the Youth Services staff to come up with all sorts of programming that run from hourly programs to daily programs to sometimes three-day programs, field trips, overnight trips, all sorts of activities from Youth Services. And Youth Services will also be open for children from 5 to 18 in these programs.
What cost is involved in the summer program?
Okay. Summer programs depends on which program you're participating in. There are three different levels of programming this summer. The 6 to 6 program, which goes from 6 in the morning till 6 in the evening, Monday through Friday. The prices range from $39 to $84 a week, depending on your family income. We have just the summer camp program, the run that goes from 9 to 4:30 Monday through Friday. The cost for that program ranges from $35 to $60 depending on your family income.
Well, in terms of what Youth Services, we have a wide variety of costs, and our costs are based on break even. We don't really make money on any of our trips, and so it's just a break even, and we cover the direct costs. So and there's such a wide variety of answers for you depending on the trip to Gardaland and how much that charges, or the trip to Potavaland, or the Kimsey trip, or the whitewater rafting, or whatever it is. So
still to come on the spot, more about summer youth programs. We'll be right back.
On my honor, I will try to serve God
and my country, to help people at all times, and to live by the Girl Scout law.
Welcome back to On the Spot. This week we're talking about youth summer programs. Now let's take more of your questions.
What does Outdoor Rec have planned for kids this summer?
Well, our main programs that we offer is the swimming lesson program, and these swimming lessons are for children ages 3 on up. We offer many different levels. It's the Red Cross programs. Our first session will be starting on June 22nd, and we will be taking registration for that session on May 16th at the PX from 10 to 2 during the YS summer sign-up program. Other things that we offer are family programs. And these activities are such as our water rafting trips. We also have hiking trips. Some of the hikes are more difficult than others, and you can just come in here and see what we have planned for each trip, and we usually have maps of everything that's going on. So we have a wide variety of everything that kids, adults can go on also.
Could you tell me what programs the Soldiers Theater have available for children this summer?
Soldiers Theater's got a wonderful summer drama camp scheduled for 2 weeks. The first one will begin June 15th and run through the 27th of June, and the second camp will begin on August 3rd and run through August 15th. It'll be taught by Bonnie Daniels, who has a master's degree in child drama from Arizona State University and one of the premier child drama specialists in America today. So we have got an extraordinary opportunity for children here and for parents to get their children involved in something that will be life-altering, life-changing for their youngsters.
Will Boy Scouts out for a camp this summer?
Boy Scouts has a summer camp planned in Germany. You can get details by calling me at 634-8595 or 341-025 at home.
Still to come on the spot, we'll take a look at some of the trips and activities YS has planned for the summer when On the Spot continues.
If you missed ITR's trip to the French Riviera last time, you're definitely not going to want to miss it again. 3 days of touring the sights, shopping, and walking on the beach. What are you waiting for?
Now for tonight's spotlight question. We've been talking about youth summer programs for kids, but now let's talk about what you have planned for this summer.
Go to Germany and tour Germany for a while.
PCSing. Yes.
Well, my wife Kelly and I are going to take our one-year-old son Michael to Livorno and check out Pisa and some of the towns around there.
See, we're going to Crete, Greece. I'm going to go back home to Washington.
Well, this summer in July, I'm going to go on the USS LaSalle and JTF Matador. I'm going to sail the Mediterranean with the Navy.
That's it for this week's edition. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you next week here.
On the Spot!
Welcome to this week's edition of On the Spot. I'm Airman Dominique Dickens, and this week our show focuses on you. Welcome to this week's edition of On the Spot. The bomb. Welcome to this. There you go. One more time. Come on the spot. We'll take a look.
At some of the. Oh, microphone's upside down.
Take a look at some of the trips and activities YS has planned for their summer program. Now, what's the last part?
I saw my leg like go over.
Hello and welcome to this edition of On the Spot. I'm Jerry Malec. Tonight we'll take a look at some volunteers in the community and we'll answer your questions about what it's like to volunteer on post. There are over 1,100 volunteers on Caserma Ederle, and tonight we'll talk to some of those volunteers. But first, let's get to some of your questions.
Why volunteer?
Volunteering helps you feel good about yourself. It helps with the community, which is really important. The community depends a lot on volunteers. And it gives you something to do if you don't have anything to do.
I volunteer because I like helping other people, and running the tutoring program gives me an opportunity to work with other people and help them learn things for their classes, and it's a lot of fun.
What makes your job as a volunteer so exciting?
I spend most of my time as the program manager for the Army Family Team Building, and I find it very exciting because I get to meet a lot of the new people in the community and actually get to teach a lot, which is something that I enjoy doing. We're offering classes, as a matter of fact, on April 20th and 21st for Level 1 training. If anyone's interested, they can call the ACS building at 8526 and we can schedule them to participate in those classes with us. I find it exciting because it keeps you up on things that are important in the military and important to families in particular.
Still to come on the spot, more about volunteering. Stay with us.
Hello, I'm Sherry Floyd. I'm the librarian of Vicenza, and this is your library, and I would like to tell you about the programs and services that we have to offer you. We're open Tuesday through Sunday from 11 to 7. Come on, follow me. This is the section in the library where we keep the new books, and if you'll notice, there are many on the bestseller list. We receive 12 new music CDs each month. If you'd rather listen to your book, we receive 6 new titles each month. Thanks to some generous year-end funding, we've been able to update the classics in our children's collection. And as all of you know, we have internet access on our public use computer. If you'd like to know more about the programs and services offered at the Post Library, I want you to feel free to come in and ask our very knowledgeable staff. And we want you to
spring in reading!
Welcome back to...